Bristol Community College Bayhawks versus Roxbury Community College.
Oh, you're the one. What? Okay.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to this edition of Bayhawks Basketball. Ladies Bayhawks Basketball, it is, at Bishop Colony High School. I'm Craig Salvador. Alongside me, as always, is Dave Cardoza. Dave, we're ready for a very exciting matchup between the, our own Bristol Bayhawks and the Roxbury Community College Tigers, as we're already on our way.
It's a big night of basketball as the city girls and the city boys coming to Bristol Community College, coming to Fall River to take on our Bayhawks doubleheader today.
Yeah, I was
looking excited to see it. The number one team in the country, Roxbury, coming in here.
Yeah, they are. And quickly, less than a minute, tie game 2-2. Megan Parrish dribbling down the court.
And the girls, they need to step up. They need to step up big today against this team.
Definitely, as you said, this is the best team in the state they're coming to face. And quick foul on number 21. That is Cherie Osborne. Had her number wrong, but they fixed it on here. Quick pass to Rosensteel, puts up for two, no good. Trying to get her own rebound, goes to the ground. And it's going to be a black ball.
BCC coming off an impressive victory over Springfield Tech on Saturday. Hopefully they can continue some of that good inspired play they had on Saturday, but they're going to need to take it to a whole another level here today, tonight.
Definitely, like you said, as we said before, it's the best team to stay. This is a long pass over to Gianna Hill, puts one up for three, and that one's good.
Textbook, nice cross court pass to Gianna Hill, who, without hesitation, puts it up for three from the wing.
Edwards now with a quick pass over to Megan Parrish. She's looking to drive. She's still driving. Going up to her right. Puts that one up, and that one's able to fall.
Wow.
2 points, Megan Parrish.
Nice drive by Megan on that one. Yep.
To her right, I know to your disapproval. Usually like to see her go to her left. Is Gianna Hill going in front of everybody. Puts that one up.
I want to see her mix it up.
Yep. Shannon Rosensteel is able to get the boards.
Roxbury looking kind of rusty here at the opening. I don't know about that call.
Yep,
I don't
know about steps that. On Rosensteel.
That was kind of. I don't think that was obvious, but.
Paying off the refs, maybe.
Oh jeez.
Maybe that's how they're the best team in the state.
Oh
I don't know.
Man, come on now.
Hey.
Now we know how Patriot haters feel.
I was going to say
what it is? Come on now.
It's 2017. It's never too early for controversy. she goes up, lays that one in off the glass. That was
number 12, Taylor Grant.
Great move by Grant going up and over everybody.
Like the hairstyle. The hairstyle kind of matches the uniform, matches the striping and the numbers and the shoes all together.
Yep, and you can read the numbers, which is great.
That's it.
We had that game where I forget what team it was against, but you couldn't read them.
Yeah, we couldn't read it, so we don't know the name of that team.
Yeah, there's a quick travel call, so this is the Bayhawks ball.
Big night of basketball here at Bishop Conley. If you're just joining us, Bishop Conley, the Holy Castle, located right next to your Bristol Community College, the beautiful campus of Bristol Community College. Roxbury comes into this game 13-1, Craig, 8-0 in Region 21, and you said they're their best team in the state. They're the best team in the region. They're the best team in the country.
Oh, blocked by Cherie Osborne. More like a punch, just really knocking that out of bounds.
That's for sure.
It was a good move, stopping the driving Megan Parrish, or actually the passing Megan Parrish. Katia Luna looking for a pass over to Parrish, who's underneath. Gives it back to Luna.
BCC can't turn the ball over against this team. Roxbury will eat you up.
They are. Hasn't been too much of a showcase yet, but game is still early. That's a nice pass out towards number three. That is Raven Smith. She puts it up, and that one's good for two.
You got to challenge them. You got to get in their face. You can't get them easy baskets. Easy floater there by number five. That was Brooklyn Davis.
It's a foul on Gianna Hill. Gianna Hill playing very aggressive defense up front.
Yes, she is. And for BCC, number 20 there, Shannon Rodensteel, if BCC's going to have a chance today, she's got to stay out of foul trouble. She's got to stay in the game.
Exactly. That was, remember, last game, or it was last game or a couple games ago, that was her problem. Everyone was in foul trouble, basically. Just fell apart at the end.
They tried to get it inside there to Deborah Banks, and they knocked it away too easy. And again, it's Brooklyn Davis.
And putting it up for two. Misa Edwards appears to be hurt.
We've seen a lot of injuries here in women's basketball. We've been calling it, Craig. Not sure what happened there. She just kind of left the court. No idea what happened. Was it a finger?
Could have been.
Did she jam a finger on that one?
Not sure. She ran out of there, so it doesn't appear to be a leg injury.
Yeah. That's the one.
Either way, Audia Contractor's in the game for her. Rodensteel, pump back,
there you
shoot
go.
For two.
That's her shot. 15 feet it in. That's Shannon Rodensteel's game.
She makes
that one.
Very great mid-range shooter, able to get in there, just put one up. Long toss over near the corner is Hill. One's good for three.
Bang. Number five, Brooklyn Davis. That's her shot over there from that wing.
Right, Brooklyn Davis, my bad. And Parrish going to her left, puts up, gets absolutely stuffed by Osborne.
I appreciate Megan Parrish's, I appreciate her drive and I appreciate her aggressiveness there, but sometimes you got to know who you're going up against. She got devastatingly blocked there.
Banks looking to throw it in someone. There's Contractor. She puts that one up. That one not able to fall. Rebounded by Hill, but Contractor pulls it back away.
That was a nice lob in. That was a nice lob pass in 80 Contractor. It was a good thought. She got good position. Nice catch, but nice catch inside, nice positioning. Nice entry pass and everything, but no lift on her layup there.
No.
Got to get a little lift.
Hill puts that one up, and that one's good for three. Such a lazy three-pointer, really.
They don't call a three, though, Craig. They only call a two, but still beat Roxbury. Man. They get up on you quick when they start shooting those outside shots.
Another bounce pass to Banks. Banks in the free throw line. They're going to call steps on her.
These refs looking to call travel real quick. You know, we love Deborah Banks. We love the boss, Deborah Banks. But this isn't going to be a game for her. She needs to be an enforcer inside. And Noah Roll today kind of box out, do the dirty work, and let Shannon Rodensteel, Megan Parrish, and also Katia Luna and Misa Edwards, let those girls do the scoring.
Misa Edwards on the bench. She appears to be icing her mouth, so she might have caught a hand or maybe the ball hit her or something.
Oh, knocked away.
That's number 12. That is Taylor Grant. Throws that up for two. Good layup.
Taylor Grant getting the passing lane with a steal.
And a timeout called for BCC.
And for a forward, for a tall girl, boy, she showed great handle in the open court. Lays it in on the opposite end. And just like that, BCC was hanging around, Craig. Now it's 18-6. Roxbury showing why they're the number one team. Around these parts, Bristol comes in today 7-10, 5-6 in Region 21, holding their own in their first year back after a year absence last year. Good to see the women's Bayhawks back. Sorry. So, Craig, you know, we talk about Roxbury being a great team, and you said they're the best team in the state. The Tigers are the defending 2015-2016 NJCAA Division III champions. Okay, and they've basically been the Duke basketball around these parts for some time now.
They're definitely looking to keep their title and really show off that title today against the Bayhawks. And right now they have a 12-point lead, 5 left in the first quarter. This is Megan Parrish. Long throw over to Luna, up and over, able to hang on to that. Nice catch. Getting over everybody.
Shot clock
running
down.
Doesn't
know
what to do with it. Gives it over to Parrish. Shot clock winding down. Nice bounce pass into no man's land, though. And here comes Grant. Up and over. Everyone in for two. Nice.
Another turnover by BCC and another layup by Grant.
That was just a careless mistake.
BCC needs to slow this game down. They're not going to get in a track meet. They're not going to get in a fast-breaking style of basketball. The way that Roxbury can score at a very alarming rate, they're not going to be able to do that. Slow the game down.
Yeah, BCC, they just had back-to-back really bad turnovers. This one's up for three.
Boy,
that one's going to fall.
Look at the friggin' rain of threes.
Raven Smith.
Looking like Steph Curry right there. And Roxbury just gets the ball right back. Wow. Lay in there by Gianni Hill.
Yep. Bayhawks need a good possession on this one. This is a nice pass over to Deborah Banks, giving it to Rosensteel. Up for two.
Easy lay in.
Good blocking by Contractor, just leaving it wide open for Rosensteel.
Sharon Rose still had a clear path to the basket. I'm not sure where the Roxbury defense was, but Contractor making a nice making room for her.
Now it's Roxbury with a turnover and another turnover, and this one just goes flying.
The last time these two teams faced each other, Craig, was back before the Christmas break. BCC lost at Roxbury's place. They lost 105-49. Hopefully we don't see that here today. Hopefully BCC can have a better showing and show that they've improved.
Yeah, not looking like that right now, but game is still very young.
Boy, that was a nice up and under move. Ooh.
And Cherie Osborne getting the rebound, able to float that one for two.
Solid.
Luna thought about three, passing it back to Parrish. Parrish dribbling, trying to get a game plan going. She's going to her left, gets stuffed again.
God, she keeps going at Cherie Osborne, and she keeps running into a brick freaking wall. You can't do that.
No.
You got to find another way to go around her. She's trying to go up and over her or into her. That's just not working out. That's an offensive foul. They call an offensive foul, Megan Parrish, for just like running up into her, and rightfully so.
We've seen Megan Parrish be able to go through lots of people, but she's not going to be able to go through her.
I like BCC better in the zone, and they get a turnover there. 2-3 zone.
Parrish going to her left again, maybe. Bounce pass to Rosensteel. Puts back, trying to get it over to Contractor. Can't get it. Gets it stolen. This is Raven Smith giving a pass back to Grant, in for two.
And that's a nice dish by Raven Smith in the open court, 2-on-1.
And that is just a very lazy move.
Raven Smith finished it nicely. God, and back on the other end, Raven Smith, before I can even get the words out, Craig, they're just scoring.
That was a very quick steal off of Megan Parrish.
Going to protect the basketball.
It's a good look over to Rosensteel. Wow, risky to Luna. She's trying to drive for it.
Almost another
bounce
steal.
A contractor. It just loses it. It's going to stay down here, but I guess it apparently went off of Taylor Grant.
BCC hasn't tried to work it inside basically mostly the whole year. And now they're looking to try to get an inside game, trying to get it into Banks and Contractor. I don't get it.
That one gets lost. Taylor Grant looking for another layup. Oh, really fakes out Megan Parrish.
You're seeing why they're the number one team in the country, Craig. Yeah, goodness gracious.
Yeah, within the first 2 minutes, showed it, like you said, maybe they were appearing a bit rusty. They are not rusty now.
Not rusty, but just got slow getting going, and now they're going. So. Yeah.
Parrish with a pass over to Rosensteel. She's going up from the free-point line. This one bouncing for a while, but no good. Rosensteel tried to save it, but ends up knocking it out of bounds.
BCC picking a bad time. They're picking a bad time to have a bad shooting night. They're not shooting well.
No, they're not shooting well, and Roxbury's been all on them.
BCC sitting in a zone. Looks like a 1-2-2 zone now with Megan Parrish at top. That's tough.
There's a travel.
There you go. Finally, Roxbury gets a travel call.
Yep. Minute 17 left in this quarter. Both teams not fouling a lot, which with me saying that means we're going to see one probably right about now.
Yeah, both teams only with two team fouls.
Megan Parrish, nice look over to Misa Edwards, looking to drive. She's going under the hoop. Wide open, Katia Luna, all the time in the world. Can't get it.
That was probably the best offensive sequence they had.
There's a shot for Edwards. That one falls for two.
Hopefully Edwards can come in here and assert herself and get a couple shots. Nice job by Misa Edwards.
Bayhawks reaching double digits now with 50 seconds left. Grant the pass to Smith. Nice bounce pass under to Brianna Pickett.
Ooh, over contractor. Was that number 14, Brianna Pickett, you said, yes.
Yep.
Pickett going right over contractor.
Edwards trying to direct traffic. She's just going to drive. She get looked like a pass. Couldn't do anything with it.
What is she doing?
The foul is on Taylor
doing a little,
Grant.
Doing apparently. A little shimmy. That's Kayla Kelly over there doing a little shimmy underneath. Roxbury feeling pretty good about themselves. Underneath to Banks. Gets it ripped away.
Trying to get it back. It's jump ball.
And you can see the talent and the over, and you can see how BCC is overmatched in the interior. The interior players for Roxbury, I mean, they can really ball.
Well, there's no doubt about it. They can go.
Because BCC can't do anything inside.
Katia Luna just throwing it off the feet of Kayla Kelly.
Kayla Kelly.
Kayla Kelly's a cool name.
I like that. Like Kelly Kelly.
Kelly Kelly. Lisa Edwards missed a shot. That one just slowly ran out of bounds. And unfortunately, we've been saying that a lot for the Bayhawks, missed that shot. So they definitely got to get their shooting down. As this, so far, their shooting's been off this game.
BCC got to get more energized.
Yeah, long throw over. With 2 seconds left, this one's put up. Nothing will happen. Contractor will get the rebound, and that'll be the end of the quarter.
That shot was on target, though, Craig. Everything that Roxbury puts up is on target.
They're defending champs for a reason.
Like, they have a bunch of girls that can shoot. So here at the end of the first quarter, 35-10.
Roxbury, very impressive. Like you said, a lot of girls who can shoot. Been seeing a lot of stealing, a lot of passing, a lot of driving. It's a lot of everything.
But mostly it's their outside shooting. I mean, their outside shooting has just been impeccable, and you can see why they're the number one team. As I said before, 13-1 record on the season, undefeated in the conference. But BCC is right in the middle. They're right in the thick of things. As far as the playoff goes, this is a time of year where, you know, teams going to start picking up their play. We're heading into February pretty soon, and that's when teams need to start picking up their play as we head towards the tournament. This is a time of year where BCC needs to start playing their best basketball, and they haven't beat Roxbury in a lot of years. They've been playing them since 2012. All L's. Not good. But, I mean, Roxbury has just had a wagon for the last several years. They've been the top team in Region 21 for some time. But BCC is 5-3 in their last 8 games. And 4-2 in their last 6 home games. So BCC's been playing better basketball since the way that they started off. We've seen some games, Craig, where the games got out of hand the first quarter, kind of like this game. We haven't seen this in a long time. BCC has been in the thick of things for a long time, so we've seen a great improvement from our Lady Bayhawks, and so they should be commended for that. But they're kind of short. They're kind of short staff. They lost Deja Eason a couple games ago. There she is down there, and they lost her to a head injury. And so that's unfortunate, because now their bench is only one deep.
Speaking of deep, there's a deep three, which is missed. That was by Kayla Kelly. But yeah, one thing about this team, BCC, is this is definitely a rebuilding team. This is going to be a team that's going to be better next year. All these people will have all these girls hopefully coming back as sophomores, and whoever else will be coming in.
Hopefully they all do return.
That one just airmailed over.
first-year head coach, Serge Moniz, who took over the ranks halfway through the season for Coach Aaron Morrell. The details of that coaching change is still undisclosed, but Coach Serge Moniz is the head coach right now. We'll see how it goes.
Ripped away from Deborah Banks. Brooklyn Davis flying, goes up, can't get it. Deborah Banks goes down with it, picks it up, passing it to Parrish.
Good hustle by Megan Parrish.
Luke. Lost it. Brooklyn Davis again. She's looking for a second chance, going up and over.
Wow.
That one lays in for two.
Oh, my goodness. So many different players for Roxbury that could just score.
Yeah. To me, Brooklyn Davis is really standing out. That one almost stolen away. Misa Edwards is able to recover. She's just looking to get this player off her back.
I'm marveling at the defense right now.
Parrish to her left, up, nothing. Swatted away. Nice save by Luna. She's going to put up a three. This one staying up a while. No good.
Roxbury's defense is just like over. I mean, it's way too intense, way overmatching BCC's offense right now.
Keisha Rayner just into the game, puts up a layup.
And as soon as she goes into a game, see, that's what I'm saying. She comes right off the bench, Keisha Rayner, and scores.
That's the thing. We see a lot of these bench players probably can also be starters on other teams.
Most definitely.
Parrish up for two, no good. And you see the look, and you look who's on the bench right now for Roxbury. Those are three players that's been big in this game already.
And there are, yeah, they're resting.
Smith looking to do something. She gives it over to Davis, puts up a three, no good, falls. Deborah Banks gets the rebound.
BCC kind of looking sluggish right now.
This team's making them run. It's not a good time to get fatigued.
Well, Roxbury, with their defense, it seems like they could take the ball over at any moment.
And they have.
It's kind of like when you're a little kid and you're playing one-on-one with your father. Mm. And, you know, or you're, like, playing one-on-one with your uncle or something, and they just, like, could take the ball at any moment.
Yeah, that was me with my older brothers.
Oh, yeah.
When your brothers are 8 and 12 years older than you, you don't score a lot when you're playing basketball with them.
Yeah, sometimes they might let you shoot it.
Yes, sometimes. No, we had a rule with my older brother. He'd play without his hands until he went on offense.
He'd play without his hands?
Yeah, so I would go up for a shot, and he would just headbutt it.
Wow.
Yeah, he'd still beat me.
That's talent.
Yeah. He's 8 years older than me, so he was always taller than me.
That's not hard to do. No. I'm sure he's still taller than you.
No, he's only got like an inch on me. I could probably beat him now.
Oh, why?
He's not listening to
this.
It's not going to matter.
You Portuguese don't grow.
No, we don't.
You get to a certain point, and it's like, that's it.
My oldest brother's like 5'9". That's about as tall in my family.
BCC sleeping right there. That should not happen. That should not happen at... Oh, my goodness gracious. What is going on now?
We got a player down. That looks like it's Shannon Rosensteel.
Coach Serge Moniz is not happy, nor should he be.
Shannon's coming out.
BCC just looks overwhelmed right now.
Yeah. Shannon Rosensteel looks dazed and confused right now. And that is something they can't afford to have. It's a long throw over to Parrish.
Yeah, they were looking to press right there.
It's knocked away. She's quickly able to recover. Passing over to Edwards.
Roxbury matching up man. One man.
Pass to Banks. Unusual spot we see Banks, but it's a necessary one. Foul on Kayla Kelly.
Huge lead, 45-10.
Yeah, this is getting crazy with Roxbury.
This is getting crazy. Yeah, it is.
It's just not surprising, really, anymore. Edwards gets thrown to the ground.
How come BCC's players keep falling to the ground?
To their own
dismay, they keep falling to the ground, but it's because It's not like Roxbury's throwing them to the ground. They're just falling. Kind of symbolic.
The LeBron James way of winning.
Oh, jeez.
That's a nice shot, but doesn't fall. It's a good attempt by Megan Parrish. Long pass over to Kayla Kelly.
Oh,
nice pass over to, that was number 11, Keisha Rayner.
Everything Roxbury does, just textbook right now. Textbook 2-on-1, way to complete that.
Yeah, Roxbury just playing pretty basketball.
And Coach serves Moniz, calls a much-needed timeout.
Interesting thing about Coach Moniz, he teaches diesel mechanics at New Bedford Vocational High School. Interesting thing about that was I was over filming basketball in Lakeville for Lake Camp, and I actually saw him there, and I was really surprised. I didn't know what he was doing there. I figured he was just recruiting, but I guess he also coaches there.
Well, I believe he went. He's a longtime friend of Coach Rob Dale Lewis. He's an alumni over at New Bedford Vocational New Bedford Regional Voc, and he also has coached their junior varsity team. So he's got a lot of ties, leads with New Bedford Voc. So. And now he's here. He started off this year as an assistant under Coach Aaron Morrell. When Aaron Morrell had to step down, Sirs Moniz is the head coach now for the last few games.
Parrish driving to her right again. Osborne is there. Foul's going to be on Osborne. So Megan Parrish will be going to the line.
You see a huge difference. It's a huge gap when you talk about Roxbury and the rest of the field here in Region 21 here in the conference. And you can see it. You see, like, when the when you see the other teams, like, it looks like their defense is so vanilla or so lackadaisical sometimes. It seems like both teams will be walking the ball up the court. A lot of teams that BCC goes against, they're able to do things. They're not able to do things against Roxbury.
Calling a travel on Osborne. Despite the travel, it's kind of amazing seeing Osborne move like that. She went through everybody all around them.
Yeah.
So it was a great move, just travel called, you know. Edwards not really sure what to do with it. No good.
Misha Edwards, one of the only girls that's getting her shot off.
Look at that pass to Osborne.
Oh, making Parrish had no chance underneath there, but a miss by Osborne.
Luna cradles it like a baby, passing it to Misha Edwards. Spin move. Gianna Hill, we've seen play up front, staying on her. Pass back to Edwards. Over to Luna. Calling 3-second violation.
Oh, that stinks. I like what BCC is doing. This is what they need to do. Against Roxbury, you can't have these long passes, these cross-court passes and such. You need to have a motion offense, and the girls need to keep moving, coming to the basketball. Hopefully someone sets a backdoor pick or something like that. They got to find ways to score.
They do, and they just haven't been finding those. Deep three by Reigns, no good in the corner. Rosa Steele comes up with it. She's back in the game.
Someone needs to light a fire. Light a fire underneath Shannon Rosa Steele.
Parrish driving to her left, gets a break. That one doesn't fall, but she's going to go to the line for two.
And I'm just looking at the body language at BCC, and it just looks like a team that's defeated right now. You know, you're down by 36, but you're down by 36. I understand that, but we're still early in the first half. Make Roxbury work for it. Make them earn it. Let them know that you're here on your own home court. Have some pride. As Megan Parrish sunk that one.
Be a sub as Osborne's coming out. And Taylor Grant's coming in.
One good thing, Roxbury has four team fouls now.
Parrish misses her second one. She's shooting 500 right now at the line this game. Up and over. That one just too good.
Nice,
Brooklyn Davis.
Nice floater there. Brooklyn Davis again.
She is a force to be reckoned with. Luna putting up a two.
Good head fake. A lot of times early in the season, we would see Katia Luna try to shoot that three. Nice up fake. Brings it in for a shorter jumper. Wow.
It is a deep three.
Wow. Goodness gracious. She watches Steph.
I was going to say, talked about earlier trying to shoot like Steph.
Yeah.
Edwards going up in the middle. That one falls for two.
Good job. Good job by BCC. Back-to-back baskets. Hopefully they heard me. Last couple times down the court, BCC with a couple successful possessions. Two of their best of the game.
Kelly with a three. That one in and out.
Yeah.
This one gets thrown.
Oh, my goodness.
Wow.
You can't let the smallest girl on the court, Gianni Hill, go in there and get a rebound and put it above the glass like it's nothing. Come on now.
Oh, she's small. She's quick. Gets knocked away. It's going to stay down to the Bayhawks.
Roxbury falling in love with that three-point shot. I guess when you're up 51-16, you got a little bit of leeway. 3 minutes and 22 seconds left in the half.
And still the nice bank shot for two.
BCC on a little 6-2 run. Moral victories. Moral victories within the game.
Little things that matter.
Well, BCC had 10 just a couple minutes ago. Now they're up to 18.
Long throw over to Davis. She's looking to drive. Going to be a foul called. Foul on Misa Edwards.
BCC needs to let Roxbury know they're here.
Also over Rayner tries to get two. This one's coming down. That is Grant.
I'm looking at a matchup here. I'm looking at Shannon Rodensteel at number 12, Taylor Grant, kind of similar builds. Kind of the same height.
Not the same hair,
but the same skill set.
Rayner looking for someone to pass it to. Long pass over to Davis. Come down with it. Hill, good pass. Over to Davis, up and in for two.
They make it look so easy at times.
It's a good passing game. This one gets knocked out. And BCC will get the benefit of the call. It's going to stay with them.
The other thing I look at with Roxbury is their offensive efficiency.
Well, just everything, like we've been saying, their offense, their defense, their way to turn the ball to them so quick.
Everybody can handle. Everybody can shoot.
So that's Luna almost into no man's land. Megan Parrish looking to do something. She's going to pop a three. This one stays up a
that
while.
Been...
No good. Rayner comes down with it. Loses that one. Edwards
there
has
you
it again.
Go.
Loses it again. That is Grant who picks it up. Goes over. Breaks Edwards. And that one's in for two.
Roxbury just has so much height.
Edwards.
They get a lot of length.
Edwards visibly frustrated with that after that showing.
Yeah, Taylor that Grant. Was tough.
Yeah, Taylor Grant just went all over her. Edwards looking to cross uphill. Gives it to Rosensteel. Almost batted away. Passing it to Parrish.
Someone come up and set a pick.
Looks like Rosensteel was about to try that. 2 seconds on the shot clock. She's going to get it off.
Ooh.
No good. Banks can't recover. New shot clock. Rosensteel from the foul line. No good. Hill with the rebound.
I would have liked to see Rosensteel kind of bring that in a little bit.
Pass to Rayner.
Look
Rayner
at that.
With a beautiful
nice pass.
Layup. Beautiful pass and a beautiful layup and a beautiful 2 points.
Who was that pass by? Brooklyn Davis?
Pass by Brooklyn Davis, I believe, is to Brianna Pinkett.
So Brianna Pinkett on the last basket. Beautiful pass, as you said, Craig, by number 5, Brooklyn Davis, showing everything that she can do.
You talk about how good this Roxbury team is. I think Brooklyn Davis is really that centerpiece in all of it. She's been showing she's really the best all-around player in this team.
And I mean, it's definitely a team. They're definitely getting key contributions from a lot of players. They work great together as a team. They're very well coached. And Craig, tomorrow, listen at 10 o'clock. Listen at 10 a.m. on BCC Radio. I'm going to be a guest on the I Love Lucy show. Our own Lucy Cabral. I'm going to be on her show tomorrow at 10. So if you get a chance, if you're awake. put on BCC radio.
That one just lost, recovered. And looked like a foul's called.
Lucy has a good little variety show, and we'll be talking about the Super Bowl, I'm sure. Patriots, Falcons, Super Bowl 51.
Why do you get to be on the show?
Because I'm awesome, Craig.
I guess I'm not awesome enough.
No, you'll get there. You'll be on the Dirty Water Sports Hour.
Is that supposed to make me feel better?
Good little secondary prize. Wow. Well, both free throws missed?
Yeah, appeared. So maybe BCC finding their kryptonite? It's at the expense of fouling them, but who knows?
BCC find Roxbury's kryptonite?
Yeah, just keep fouling them. Miss all the shots, get the rebounds. Probably not going to work, but...
You watch too many Marvel... You read too many Marvel books.
Kryptonite's not Marvel, though.
Too many Marvel comic books. Kryptonite? Superman? That's not Marvel?
It's DC.
Oh, yeah. That's right. Mm-hmm. Spider-Man's Marvel.
Spider-Man's Marvel.
Hulk.
Yep.
All of them.
Shannon Rosenstiel sinking both of them. And that's something BCC needs is points any way possible.
Come on. Give this Fall River crowd, give them something to cheer about. What a silent crowd.
And the men's team is not impressed.
Well, they're down by 36.
I mean, they can be impressed with the other team.
Yeah, they probably are.
They just don't want to show it.
Oh, man. Like okay. I said, moral victories. I mean, the second half, win the second half. Play better in the second half. You got to build towards something. Last time these two teams played on December 15th, Roxbury scored 105 on you. Limit them to underneath that. Limit them to under 100.
Well, if the law of averages say anything right now, it's not looking like that's going to happen. Parrish puts that one up for
nice
two.
Nice drive. Nice drive all the way around, then going baseline with that floater. Kind of one of her staples. Good job by Megan Parrish there.
Hill with 30 seconds remaining. Gives it over to Davis. That one over to Pinkett.
All right, Deborah Banks ripping the ball away.
She's got to do something with it. She's going to give it to Misa Edwards. Edwards looking to drive. She's going to throw it up. Gets stuffed by Raven Smith.
She probably should have passed it. Oh, God.
That is a charge.
And they're going to call a...
Oh, it's on Deborah Banks.
She must have not had the position. I mean, she came right in there, a full head of steam, dipped the shoulder, and knocked Deborah Banks to the floor.
Well, the boss can't believe it. So, 10 seconds left. Davis, she sinks her first one. That was Deborah Banks' third personal of the game. Missed the shot back up. Easy. Wow.
Coach Serge Moniz is not the vocal type. We don't hear him barking like the other coaches or like the previous coach here. You know, so definitely a different coaching style.
Parrish got to put it up, but she loses it instead.
Was hoping to see another buzzer-beating three-pointer at the half, but nothing doing. And BCC has some work to do down 39 here at the end of the first half.
Dave Cardoza with the mental math.
The mental math. The mental math. The mental midget with the mental math.
So we go into half, as he said, score 63-24 in favor of the Tigers. So...
Yep, and we've seen the Roxbury women kind of spread it out with their scoring. And BCC goes to the locker room, and they have a lot of work to do, Craig. So.
Yep, so we're definitely doing for an exciting second half one way or another. So see how they can do when we come back.
So what do you think, Craig? Selfie Nation over here.
Yep, sending a Snapchat. Shout out to my girl, Gracie. She's not listening, but I'll tell her to listen.
Aw, Gracie. My grandmother's name was Gracie. It's a great name. All right, so we're getting ready for the second half here at Bishop Connolly High School, the Holy Castle. Roxbury, the number one team in the country, the defending national champions. Now to Craig Salvador.
Sup. this one quickly went out of bounds. It's staying in the Bayhawks ball. So
I got to keep you on point, Craig. Sometimes I don't know if you realize you're doing the play-by-play.
No, I know what I'm doing. So it's a pass into Megan Parrish. She's crossing up over to Shannon Rosensteel. She's looking to drive. Step back, look for a shot, but doesn't get it. She's going to give it to Parrish. Shot clock down to 13. Rosensteel thrown into 80 a contractor. Back to Rosensteel. No good.
Not a good way to start.
Nope. This pass over to Davis.
God,
Davis for
it
two.
Look too damn easy.
This is the first points of this half.
Taylor Grant with a nice dish. Flips it back to the trailer.
It's an unselfish basketball from Roxbury.
Very, very unselfish team.
Grant almost got the steal. Rosensteel now with the pass up and over.
Oh, that's going to go off Misha Edwards.
Yeah.
It was tipped.
Yeah,
it was tipped by number two, Kayla Kelly, but it was also off the hands of Misha Edwards.
Yeah, it was really instinct from Edwards trying to bring it down.
Yeah, can't falter for that.
And Edwards was blessed with a lot of things, but height was not one of them.
Yeah, BCC with not too much height. Not too much length.
Not too much scoring either.
Not today.
Pass to Grant, who gives it back. Throw in. I don't know how Osborne caught that. Fouls on Contractor, and I'm still just impressed that even with Contractor and Banks right there, Osborne still came away with it.
Yeah.
It was really threading the needle.
Don't underestimate her. Nice inbound play. Osborne there.
Yep. They just keep getting the ball back. Osborne up for two. Still no. That was just miscommunication. As you saw, I believe it was Rosensteel and Banks, I believe both went up. Missed it.
Deborah Banks with a half-hearted effort to go get that basketball. That was clearly off the Bayhawks, and she kind of let that one just skip out of bounds.
This one to Osborne. Osborne up from the paint. No good.
Nice position by Osborne.
And Roxbury just keeps getting second chance after second chance.
Yeah, you can't. If you're BCC, you can't let that happen.
No, you can't afford to let that happen at this point.
And BCC coming off a 100-point-plus effort against Springfield Tech. Only 24 points today.
You remember when we were playing Springfield Tech, they had one player who was doing everything. Now they got every player doing it all in Roxbury.
Exactly right.
Megan Parrish with a little bit of a highlight of the game, though, going through everyone getting that layup for two.
It's going to be Megan Parrish time.
Kelly for three. That one no good.
Where did she come from?
I believe that was Brianna Pinkett out of nowhere.
You got to block out. You got to find your matchup, and you got to block out. Put a body on her. No one saw her coming. She got right in there.
Nope.
And BCC had a lot of players down there.
Yeah, she came out of nowhere just like an RKO. Not really sure what happened there.
Contractor just can't connect on that one. Too much.
Kelly looking to drive. Puts it up. No good. Banks with the rebound. Gets taken away by Osborne. Osborne with some fadeaway action. Banked in for two.
Osborne took that away from the boss, Deborah Banks, like nothing. Deborah Banks, who had a great game on Saturday, Craig, not playing well today.
No, but really not a lot of people are. I'm surprised Rosensteel didn't get called up and down. Guess she didn't leave the floor. There's a nice pass to Parrish. Thought about shooting it. Decides to drive. Giving it to Edwards. Edwards puts it up for three. Well short.
Oh, I think Grant might have got a piece of that.
That is some nice passing.
Wow,
picture perfect.
Brooklyn Davis with the pass to Grant, but it was started by number 14, Brianna Pickett, with the length of the court pass.
Great give and go action.
Great give and go action.
And they planned that. It was beautiful. This is not so beautiful. Davis just taking it away from Parrish. Parrish up, easy two.
Brooklyn. Brooklyn time.
They've dropped 75 points in almost 2.5 quarters.
Man, Brooklyn over here getting gangster on Fall River. Roxbury. Yep. Roxbury getting gangster on the ladies from Fall River.
We're Fall River. I thought we were the most gangster.
Oh, man. 75 of 26, Craig. Not looking good for the Lady Bayhawks.
Nope, not at all. Just got to really come back and play their game. But their game's just been stopped by Roxbury.
That's for sure. Roxbury, number one team. We know that. And, BCC's last game was on Saturday. And I'm sorry, they didn't score 100 points in that game. It was a 78-51 victory against Springfield Tech. They got Roxbury tonight. Their next game is on Saturday. It's a road game at Holyoke. And then they round out the January schedule at the Naval Prep. They beat Navy Prep earlier in the season, 74-69. And, they have three road games in a row. So we won't be calling actually four road games in a row, Craig. So the next women's game we call will be against Quinsigamon, and that's not till February 7th. They play Holyoke, Naval Prep, and they're at the University of Connecticut at Avery Point the next three games. So three road games for the Lady Bayhawks coming up.
That'll be our first game after the Super Bowl where we'll surely be crying, hopefully with tears of joy.
We'll be out of action.
Been over Rosensteel for two, no good. I mean, is it joy? It's definitely joy, but I feel like we'd be used to it. But
I get a little choked up sometimes in the post game.
Yeah, the post game. I mean, last time
I gotta kind of smack myself.
I mean, last time we won was definitely a crying moment. 2013 Red Sox was definitely a crying moment, just with everything that year.
2004.
2004 is the most crying moment.
That was the most crying moment. The best thing wasn't even the World Series. To me, it was to come back against the Yankees, down 3-0. They come back and win that. Just, you ever watch 4 Days in October?
Oh, great documentary.
Oh, my God. Hard to get through that one without some.
Yeah. Still the only team ever to do that.
Start feeling the emotions in that one.
Yeah, I think Kevin Euclid said this. It was someone. They said 2004 was for the parents and the grandparents, and 2007 was for the kids when they won again.
Oh, yeah.
And then 2013 was for the city, I think, is what Ortiz said.
Never heard it put as eloquently as that. That's true.
Yep. Don't quote me on that. I would take credit, but it'd be probably plagiarism. I think it's from the 2000s.
I don't think so. Not if he didn't trademark it.
Not if he didn't trademark it. Okay, I'll go out and trademark it.
Yeah. You can trademark it now. Yep.
Meanwhile,
nice.
Rosensteel with a nice
Why
two.
Can't we see more of that from Shannon Rosensteel? Shannon Rosensteel gets the ball right down there, down low, in the front court. Drives the baseline. Nice strong drive and a nice little floater to tickle the twine.
Yeah, exactly. They do need more of that. BCC, they got that one, but BCC weren't getting a lot of rebounds in this game. Luna thinking about a three, but she just gets choked up. She's going to drive.
Why doesn't Shannon Rosensteel make herself available? Why is she watching ladies like Katia Luna? We love Luna, but why are you watching players that you know are not going to do anything with the basketball when they're driving? Go make yourself available.
Meanwhile, she has it. She's going to give it to Parrish. Maybe she's worried about getting into foul trouble. There's a pick.
It doesn't matter at this point.
Yep. Big bounce pass to Kelly. Kelly puts it up.
They must work on that.
Two.
God, that's an awesome pass by Gianni Hill. I love the bounce pass in the open floor.
Yeah, Roxbury definitely in the Bayhawks' heads.
BCC getting run out of their own gym right now.
A little contact.
Nice.
Parrish to her left, in for two.
Going to her left aggressively and putting it up with her right.
Yep, they cut down the lead to 49.
Megan Parrish has some good quickness about her. Got a good first step.
As she does. That was a shot. It's more or less all I can say about that.
Look up.
Up here comes Rosensteel.
There you go.
Putting that one up for two.
A pass from Luna to Rosensteel.
It was a long throw over to Kelly. Kelly with that three, Lofton up and down. So Rosensteel has it. The thing I think we talked about Rosensteel last game was she seemed kind of hesitant to put up shots and layups, but that showing, she did a good job.
Honestly? Honestly, I think she's tired. Honestly, I don't think she's...
Well, we saw her go down.
I feel like she's winded.
We saw her go down earlier and didn't really see what happened.
Yeah.
We saw her go down. She definitely seemed pretty dazed when she got up. It kind of looked like she just needed a nap.
Yeah, hopefully she doesn't have a concussion.
No, that is, like we said, something that Bayhawks definitely can't afford. Especially with someone as vital as Shannon Rosensteel is. She sets a pick, threading the needle to Misa. No good. Contractor tried to come down with it, but can't do anything. This is going to be Roxbury's ball. Hill dribbles it up. And just nothing to say about it. They're making it look easy. Bayhawks barely an attempt. 81-32, 2:23 left in this third quarter. Both teams far in the half, each with one foul each. There's a nice pass to Parrish. She puts that one up.
Ooh,
can't get down.
Parrish
Kayla
can't
Kelly
connect
has
in the layup.
It. Two bags, that would have been nice, but no go.
Nothing nice about that.
Nope. And here comes the three. No good. Roxbury hasn't been having their three game this far in this half.
Roxbury doesn't. They don't need to, and obviously.
That was just a lazy mistake.
Oh my goodness! Just as you turn your head.
That was just lazy mistake.
Raven Smith with the lay-in.
Yeah, coming out of nowhere to steal it. You know, if you think at this point, you know, you can just get an easy put, easy pass in, easy throw in. Raven Smith says, "Nah."
Nah.
No, she's like, nah, I'm going to get him many points as possible.
See, Shannon could get her shot underneath there.
Now you're talking about falling over nothing again. Rosensteel went down again. Just got crossed up too much by Gianna Hill.
And I got the scoop on Shannon Rosensteel. Apparently, you know, she grew up in, she's from Sunrise, Florida, went to Western High School. Apparently, she wasn't even one of the top players on her high school team. Didn't get much playing time in her senior year. But she was recruited by Coach Amarell, who has ties to the community down there in Florida. A lot of ties around everywhere. But recruited her, and she's kind of slowly has become the go-to gal on this Lady Bayhawks team. And she's averaging 15 points and 8 rebounds a game. It is one of the top 10. You know, top 12 scorers in Region 21, so.
And she must have went to a very good high school if they didn't play her.
Yeah. That's just a scoop.
Is it from a credible source?
Oh, it's from a credible source.
Is it from a primary or secondary source?
It's from a very credible source.
Is it from her?
No.
Jonah Hill with some handles. There's a nice pass over to Smith. She puts it up, can't get it down.
Yeah, that was a nice pass. Threading the needle, but Roxbury can't make the shot.
It's being... Luna
there
puts up
go.
A three. Haven't seen Luna with too many threes this game. She
no,
misses that one.
No, she has not. She has not been able to get her shot off.
It is a great pass. And absolutely no one on her. Lays it in for two.
Just a layup throw at Roxbury.
Yep, Keisha Rayner making it rain.
Making it rain.
Bling, bling, dolla, dolla.
The rain woman.
The rain. No, never mind. I was trying to make like a Roman Reigns joke, but then I remembered he said the Roman Empire, so it wasn't like I couldn't make anything out of that.
God, I hate Roman Reigns.
I think everyone does.
He doesn't do it for me. He's got he does the Royal Rumble this Sunday. But Roman Reigns doesn't do it for me. He's got. I think he's got the look. He's got everything. But his mic skills. He's
not charismatic.
He's just a dope. I think he has charisma without saying anything. But he just. I don't know, man.
It's fun when he's beating people.
He's gonna
up.
Be a heel.
That's what everyone says. You know.
Turn him heel already. Everybody's much better when they're heel.
Pretty much.
I'm not a good guy. I'm not a bad guy.
Dean Ambrose
I'm
is
the
guy. Dean Ambrose's thing when he won the championship was the best thing. He's like, Seth was the man, Roman was the guy. What does that make me, the dude?
Which was such.
Yeah, that was Dean Ambrose. This one's deep for three. No
dude,
good.
What does that
Can't
make
get
me
the
the dude?
Rebounds. And just like that, the third quarter comes to an end, 87-34.
When you start talking about WWE right now, you know it's a blowout in the house.
Yeah.
Goodness gracious.
I mean, maybe that's what we need, Roman Reigns, just to come out and spear everybody.
He still has the Shield music, which is pathetic.
Yeah, everyone else got their own. He could come out through the crowd, you know. Be kind of easy to see, but... I mean, if a 6.5-foot Samoan guy came from this crowd, I'd probably notice.
He's still wearing the vest. Why is he wearing the vest?
It makes him look bigger.
You think so?
No, that's actually the reason. If you look at Roman Reigns without his vest, like...
I don't think he's that big.
He's not that big.
He's big, but he's not...
He's not that big.
I don't think he's jacked.
That's why he wears the vest. It makes him look bigger.
Really?
Yeah. That's legit. That's actually the reason.
Wow, okay.
Yeah.
So he doesn't look jacked with his shirt off, then?
No, not really. Well, he's big. Like I said, it's not like he's not
but
big.
He's
but
not
he's not
jacked up. He's not like
he's
ripped.
He's not Triple H like or he's John Cena or them. He's just he's kind of
maybe he's got some man boobs going on.
Could be trying to hide that.
I'm not sure if you remember The Rock back in the day. He used to wear this shirt for a little bit because
he had the man boobs problem.
Yeah, he had the man boobs. He was getting the surgery done. Maybe
yeah,
he's got.
I did hear about
was thinking
that.
About something like that.
Maybe, it's common in Samoans apparently.
I guess. Common with steroids.
Yeah, that too. That's actually the real thing. It is actually common in Samoans and steroid use.
It's very common. That's what happens with the steroids because they don't take the proper hormones with it. They just take. They don't know what they're doing.
No.
I don't know this from prior knowledge, from prior use or anything. Am I getting defensive?
Just a little bit.
All right, so there's a basketball game going on.
Yeah, that there is. We will probably continue to make wrestling references because we need some way to live with this beatdown. Maybe the men's game will be a little bit better.
Yeah, the men's basketball game following this game right here. The Bayhawks come in here with the men's team, 10-3, 10-3 in the region. All regional games this year. They'll take on Roxbury in the 8 o'clock matchup, the prime time matchup. BCC, the Bristol Community College men's team, number one team in Region 21 right now. Them and Bunker Hill are neck and neck. But BCC boasts the top record. They boast the top team and in the conference, so... They'll see if they can pull ahead to 11-3 tonight. Still got that many games left, Craig. We got like a handful of games left before we get to playoff time, before we get to tourney time.
We're getting down
it's
to
that
the
time of year.
Getting down to the nitty gritty.
It's gonna be time for the madness.
And just as a side note, when Bayhawks they were getting their cheer, everyone just seemed defeated. You know, just kind of ready to give up. And there's 9.5 minutes left. You're down by this much. Down by 53.
Three-pointer just drained effortlessly by number two, Kayla Kelly.
Do you think right now the Bayhawks, do you think that they should kind of just conserve their energy and kind of live with the defeat, or do you think that they should still try as hard
as
they can?
No, they should. You can't stop. You've got to go. You're going up against the best, so why not measure yourself up against the best?
Yeah. There's a steal after a steal. Then Rosensteel missed the shot.
They do look very tired, though.
Kelly over,
nice.
Kelly over Edwards up for two. Just all these names.
I think that was
Keisha
Rayner, right? That was number 11, Keisha Rayner with that pass.
was with a pass. It was Kelly who went up for the two.
And Rainer blocks the heck out of Edwards there.
Yeah. Blocked like a Twitter hater.
Blocked like a Twitter hater. Oh, man.
Edwards shoots that one.
Nice.
That one goes in.
They'll only give her two. She had her foot on the line. Unfortunate. That was a nice shot by Misha.
There's a pass to Kelly. Kelly throws that one up, too. No good. Parrish with the rebound. She's looking to drive underhand
nice.
And in.
Megan Parrish, the leading scorer for the Bayhawks today by far. She's the only thing that can get. She's the only gal that can get anything going offensively.
Davis with the pass to Rainer. Rainer lays it in. That one's good for two.
All of a sudden, Rainer's coming here and is a huge scorer now. All of a sudden, she's like a scoring machine.
Told
coming
you.
Off the bench, Keisha Rainer.
Told you, making it rain. Edwards driving through, and so no good. It's going to be on her.
I can't even tell right now, looking at both benches, I can't even tell what team was. If you didn't look at the scoreboard, you just kind of look at the two benches, can't really tell right now who's winning or losing. Roxbury just over there chilling. Like, we got this one. It's another day at the office.
Yep.
For the Roxbury Tigers.
Jeez, I would have liked to see the game they lost. Like, someone able to beat this team.
I'm not sure who they lost to.
Well, there's a lazy play.
But it wasn't anybody in the region. It was a non-conference game.
Edwards this time for three. No good off the front of the
She's
rim.
She's got that line drive shot. That bangs off the rim. Ooh, way
Kelly,
too
Kelly.
Far ahead.
Now you're making me say it. Kayla Kelly. That is, she –
You love saying that name, Kayla Kelly.
I know, but I said Kelly Kelly by accident.
Kelly Kelly.
Getting back on the wrestling thing.
Oh, jeez.
Holla. Yeah.
Johnny Hill had her teammate wide open there. She overthrew her by a lot.
Yeah, Kelly tried throwing on the Jets, but, you know, just extinguished the flame, couldn't get it.
Pass Roxbury sitting back in zone now.
Travel. Ooh.
Moving that pivot foot.
And I was talking about Kayla Kelly throwing on the Jets. It looked like Rosensteel had a first-class ticket right there. Travel joke, Dave. I'm funny. My broadcast partner, Dave Cardoza, completely ignoring me.
Well, when you have a headset where you can't hear the person in your ear, it's kind of tough.
Yeah, I don't know what's wrong with it.
It's our camera woman's fault. Don't worry. Lucy couldn't solve it either. I feel like Lucy's like your mom.
Lucy is a very nice person, as our camera woman has said.
We got Lucy's daughter over here on Thursdays.
Deep three.
And then you're just like her.
Megan Parrish, the bounce pass to Luna. Bounce pass again to Banks. Banks throws it up. No good. Osborne with the rebound. Parrish now gets it. Throw to Rosensteel. Plants it, puts it up, 2 points.
There you go, Shannon.
Yeah, that's some work being able to
I feel
to
like Shannon
Kelly.
Gets her points no matter what, but, you know.
No, she's definitely, she gets her fix no matter what, but just score wouldn't show that.
Gets her fix? Does she have a fix that we don't know about now? Her fix.
I mean, points are a good addiction.
We got to look ahead. Nice pass by Banks.
Kelly giving chase.
Nice, there you
Parrish
go, Deborah.
Throw it up, gets two. We talk about Deborah Banks wasn't a...
That was a nice outlet pass.
Yeah. We were talking about how big of an impact she was last game. She was named to the all-tournament team for the NHCI
tap-off.
Yeah,
that was a long time ago, Craig.
It says on the sheet of stuff I need to know.
10 things you need to know? Yeah. That was so passe. But Deborah Banks, yeah, she was named to the all-tournament team and won the tip-off classic over there. But Deborah Banks was great. She was great in the last game. Double-double. You know, she's going to get double figures in rebounds. She had 15 points last game against Springfield Tech. So, non-existent today, though.
Rose a steal from the three-point line. No good. Osborne picks it up.
Well, bringing the ball off the court was Osborne. Shouldn't have threw that one.
Rosensteel stopped in no man's
land.
Osborne trying to take it.
Oh, goodness gracious.
That was just a little aggressive.
I give it to Cherie Osborne. She's in it to win it, man. Ripping that ball away. She's an enforcer down there. Intimidation.
Misa Edwards tried to set a pick, tried to give Megan Parrish a lane, but it doesn't work. She draws a foul.
5:18. And then we'll be getting ready for the men's and JCAA matchup against Roxbury. The men basketball team, the Bayhawks, and the second part of this doubleheader.
Davis with no one on her puts up a three, no good.
Roxbury is able to set their feet. There's Grant with another offensive rebound for Roxbury. Roxbury able to set their feet on these three-point shots and shoot them comfortably.
Long
that shouldn't happen.
Throw to Luna. Bounce past the contractor, back to Parrish.
Good ball movement by BCC.
Can't get that one to fall, though. Here's a long throw. Davis is going to save it, can't get a shot off.
Oh, geez.
They're going to call travel.
Well, she had a chance to pass that to one of her teammates. And Roxbury's been playing unselfish, but.
Looked like she might have tried to be a little selfish. Kind of looked like she was trying to go over Misa Edwards and try to bank a two.
I don't know.
Just kind of tripped over herself, threw it away. Edwards for three. Overshot.
Higher arc on that shot right there, but way off the mark.
Yeah, that's Brianna Pinkett gets away with it. This one gets thrown away. She's going to go to the line.
This team goes deep.
Foul on Shannon Rosensteel. It's only her second of the game.
Roxbury's showing what champions are all about. I mean, they go deep, man. Kelly and Brooklyn Davis, Johnny Hill, Keisha Rayner, Taylor Grant, Brianna Pickett, all getting in on the action. And then Cherie Osborne, she's been a force to be reckoned with.
Roxbury, they're going to try.
Raven Smith, I mean, everybody. I don't think we haven't seen Anna Marcellin in this game. We've seen everybody else kind of contribute.
I don't think she's here tonight.
She might not be here because she would be in this game contributing, I'm sure. Number 31, Anna Marcellin, freshman forward.
This team made up majority of
freshmen. They only have two sophomores. This is a new group.
It's very interesting, actually. I just noticed that, too. But either way, they're gonna try to make like Drake and bring it back to back. But it going back to back.
That's what I mean.
On.
It's hard to have like a dynasty in junior college sports because these players are leaving year after year. You're recycling players every couple of years. This team is made up of all freshmen, so I mean, most of these players don't have no recollection of what happened last year of a national championship team. These are all new. This is a new squad.
It's good coaching. Edwards lost it. She falls to the ground. Bayhawks with a case of the jelly legs this game.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Amen. In the Holy Castle.
Yep. It's a contractor kicked away. It's not really anything else to talk about.
Sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah.
It's raining men, hallelujah. And that one falls in Fall River again.
You must be a good little Catholic Portuguese boy. Did you go to CCD?
I did. My parents made me, but I did.
Yeah, I went to CCD too.
Wow, 99-44. It's a nice set of numbers. Two of the greatest of all times wear those numbers. You got Jay Crowder, then Brian Scalabrine, greatest of all times. The White Mamba.
The White Mamba.
Funny story. Friend of mine actually got his phone signed by Brian Scalabrine.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I remember you mentioning that.
I don't know if I told it
that
on the air.
That was a big moment in his life, I'm sure.
Yeah. I don't know if I told that story on the
air. Might as well get your phone signed by Ronald McDonald.
Yeah. It's a story I'm probably going to have to bring on the, was it the Dirty Water Sports
Radio? Dirty Water Sports Hour, tell the world.
Yeah.
Sure, they'll be thrilled. Jumper there by Brooklyn Davis. Ooh, snatching that rebound was Osborne.
Now, Roxbury breaks it, breaks the 100-meter. Century mark. She still gets on the lay, and she hits the ground really
Megan.
Hard.
Megan limping after that. Hope she's okay. But Megan, yeah, smashing. Yeah. One thing about Megan, she don't care.
Now, she's not afraid to throw the body.
If she's going
to
go out, she's going to go out in a blaze of glory.
It just shows the type of competitor it is. You got this game. You're down by 50. You're down by 55, and she's still giving it all she has just to lay that in. You know, there's no quitting her.
She's been relentless. You know, I think of Cherie Osborne as like an intimidator down there, but Megan Paris doesn't care. She's driving it right into her. It's like almost she's like she's going down there and commits suicide.
No, she's a competitor.
You know.
Up and over, don't got, the ups.
She's got a quiet competitiveness about her. You know, it's not like in your face, but she's going to drive. She's not going to be scared. She's going to get in there, and whatever happens, happens.
No, she's kind of like the type of person. She's not going to trash talk, but she drains a three or goes up for a layup. She's going to give you, like, a look.
Oh, yeah. Well, like, she was – her and Jamie Staples from Springfield Tech were going at it on Saturday.
Yeah, this – jump ball. This possession just went everywhere.
And I still hope to see Stales and Parrish in a Hell in the Cell matchup.
Well, we saw in the men's game, I think it was Danny Mendez, looked like he did an arm drag to someone.
No, I think he was. Wasn't he the one that got arm dragged?
No, he like went up and over. I don't know. It looked like he went up and over someone and looked like the other guy kind of fell down. Or looked like he was going to get cradled.
Arm drag.
Wrestling, we can never escape it.
You can't. It is life.
Misa Edwards probably should have let that one go. Megan Parrish would have had a better chance at it.
Yeah, you can always compare real life situations to wrestling.
More often than not, it just doesn't go how you want it to.
Yeah, nice entry pass down inside.
You know,
she's a good passer, Gianni Hill.
You can say that, I think, about everyone on this team, good passers.
Yeah, they definitely can. A lot of their players definitely could do multiple things well. What makes them such a good group? It's going to be a tough group to stop as we enter the month of February pretty soon here. Mm-hmm. Roxbury looking to, well, it's kind of a foregone conclusion now, 102-47.
Audio contractor checks in for Shannon Rosensteel. So Davis puts that one up, and that one's going to score. So I think she went 2 for 2 on the foul shots.
You got to think, being a coach for Roxbury, recruiting, they get a lot of girls. They get a lot of girls from the inner city. I'm sure in Roxbury itself, but I'm sure also in Boston. In the city of Boston, they get a lot of the meat from there. Oh. A lot to choose from.
Banks went up for a layup, and she just got robbed by Brianna Pinkett.
Ooh, look at the handle by Grant.
Rainer now.
Roxbury is not turning off the. They had not turned out the Jets. They are like the Patriots. They're running up a score right now.
They're here to prove a point. Here to show why they're champions.
Right. I mean, they're not sitting on the basketball. Like they're, you know, they're not. I wouldn't say they're going full throttle, but they're just playing, and they're just scoring. They're just accumulating points. Like they just continue to play basketball.
Yeah, I definitely saw that right from the moment they were up. Like they were at like 94 points. We were at like I think 40 still. And Raven Smith, she came out of literally nowhere on a pass in and just stole it, put up a layup.
Yeah, I mean that's. You got to put the foot on the throat. I mean, I think the foot's been on the throat since the opening quarter.
But the foot's on the throat, the hands over the face, just everything is happening.
BCC is 6 foot deep right now. The plot has already been buried. The plot has already had the dirt dumped in it.
Yeah, the ashes have been spread.
The grass has already grown. Like the headstone is already there. Yeah, it's over with.
Contractor gets stuffed again.
Dave Cardoza, the Grim Reaper.
Yeah.
Rest in peace.
I think they're still trying to put him in a program with John Cena.
That should happen.
They wanted it too. Like, I think they wanted that last year, then Cena got hurt. So they gave him Shane McMahon.
Cena should have been, he should have been the one that ended the streak.
They could have.
Not Brock Lesnar.
They could have done a cool storyline, made Cena a heel out of that.
Cena should be a heel.
I mean, he's already booed by half the crowd as is.
Let's go, Cena.
Cena sucks. No, I like the thing they did. I think they started it like, I think it was a couple years ago. They sing his entrance song, John Cena sucks.
Oh, yeah.
John Cena sucks. But he embraces it. He does like, he conducts them when he comes down.
He's ridiculous,
he's
man.
He's very ridiculous. Remember the John Cena meme where it's like you're watching something and then John Cena would just come up like for no reason?
Are you sure it was a Cena?
Yeah, no, it was like something would happen and then it would be like, it's John Cena. Like that.
I don't think I've seen that
Oh,
one.
Yeah, that was a big thing
last year. I've seen the Randy Orton, like the RKO, out of nowhere. Just
yeah. Well, this one's different. It's not really like people falling. It's just like, you know, like take... Like, the big one is, like, take the Eminem song. It's like, hi, my name is what? My name is who? My name is
John Cena. You know whose show you need to go on? You need to go on It Factor Radio. That's on Thursday after the Dirty Water Sports Hour.
Oh, yeah? You're talking about unrelenting 17 and a half seconds. Get it right back. Put it in for two. 110 to 47.
Sorry to bore you with our inane wrestling talk, but...
Yeah, I mean, we got 10 seconds left in the game. I have no idea what just happened.
Great block. Great block there by number 14, yeah. Brianna Pinkett.
I mean, BCC in this game, they're getting stuffed more than like a Thanksgiving turkey.
80 contractor can't connect. I feel bad for her
put
sometimes.
Put it up.
Right to the last horn. Roxbury's chucking up shots.
I don't think that would have counted. I think she threw it late, but if it fell in, that still would have been cool.
The fact that she threw it up there, up 110 to 47 here in the fourth quarter.
Yep.
And unfortunately for BCC, they're going to fall to 7-11 and 5-7 now in regional play. Roxbury advances to 14-1, 8-9-0 now in Region 21. So Serge Moniz and his Bayhawks fall today. They have another game on Saturday against Holyoke and another game at Naval Prep next week, next Tuesday. That game at the Naval Prep on January 31st. So those are the games that will round out the month. For BCC, I thought Megan Parrish and Shannon Rosedeal, you know, did what they could, but Roxbury is way too much. They're defending national champions. They have a culture of winning there, and Roxbury is the top team in Region 21, top team of the country, and that's just the way it is right now. So
exactly. And just to put a little light on things, who do you think our Bayhawks player of the game was?
Our Bayhawks player of the game, I'm going to give it to Megan Parrish. I thought she was the only one that could really develop, I mean, really kind of create her own shot. And she's got to be the leading. She's the leading scorer for BCC here today. So everybody else looked like they were asleep for BCC. So Megan Parrish doing what she does, hustling, being aggressive, and just playing, you know, just doing what she can for this team. I thought everybody else was asleep. So for Megan Parrish, I thought she was the only one that played anything that resembled inspired basketball. So Megan Parrish will be our Lady Bayhawks player of the game in a defeat here today at Bishop Conley.
Yep, Megan Parrish, well-deserving recipient. Anyway, so a lackluster game tonight for the Bayhawks. Stay tuned later for the as we will be covering the men's game. So from Bishop Conley High School, for FR Media and Dave Cardoza, I'm Craig Salvador.
I want to say, look for all these games on YouTube on our Bayhawks channel there. Look for the games on YouTube. You can find the men and women's basketball games on YouTube if you want to see any past games. So
like
that's
I said,
it.
So we'll catch you soon.